William Crapo "Billy" Durant was a leading pioneer of the United States automobile industry, who created the system of multi-brand holding companies with different lines of cars, and the co-founder of General Motors with Frederick L. Smith, and of Chevrolet with Louis Chevrolet. He also founded Frigidaire. Biography: born in Boston, Massachusetts, Durant was the son of William Clark Durant and Rebecca Folger Crapo, who was born to a wealthy Massachusetts family of French descent, she being the daughter of Michigan Governor Henry H. Crapo. William dropped out of high school to work in his grandfather's lumberyard, but by 1885, he had partnered with Josiah Dort to create the Coldwater Road Cart Company. He started out as a cigar salesman in Flint, Michigan, and eventually moved to selling carriages. He founded the Flint Road Cart Company in 1886, eventually transforming $2,000 in startup capital into a $2 million business with sales around the world. By 1890, the Durant Dort Carriage Company, based in Flint, had become a leading manufacturer of horse-drawn vehicles, which ultimately became number one in the world. Durant also conceived the modern system of automobile dealer franchises. When approached to become general manager of Buick in 1904, he made a similar success and was soon president of this horseless vehicle company. In 1908, he arranged the incorporation by proxies of General Motors and quickly thereafter sold stock, and with the proceeds acquired Oldsmobile. The acquisitions of Oakland, Cadillac, and parts companies followed in a short order. Originally, Durant was highly skeptical of cars, thinking that they were stinky, loud, and dangerous, to a point where he would not let his daughter ride in one. By 1900, public outcry for government regulation of gasoline-powered horseless carriages was significant. Durant heard this outcry, and rather than relying on government regulations to improve their safety, saw an opportunity to build a successful company by improving on the safety of these new machines. To accomplish this, he sought out the purchase of Buick, a local car company with few sales and large debts. Equals General Motors equals. In 1904, Durant began realizing his vision of building the car industry. Starting from virtually nothing, he used his sales skills to enter Buick into a New York auto show, returning with orders for 1,108 cars. Durant and Samuel McLaughlin of Canada signed a 15-year contract to build Buick powertrains at cost plus. They were called McLaughlin until 1942. Durant went back to Detroit to start General Motors Holding Company at the suggestion of his partner McLaughlin, CEO of McLaughlin Car Company of Canada. Durant founded General Motors Holding Company on September 16, 1908, with $500,000 in Buick stock that Durant traded McLaughlin for $500,000 of McLaughlin stock, making McLaughlin one of General Motors' biggest shareholders. On October 26, 1909, General Motors Holding acquired the Carter Car Company, founded 4 years earlier in Jackson, Michigan, by Byron J. Carter. In explaining the reason he purchased Carter Car, Durant said, "They say I shouldn't have bought Carter Car. Well, how was anyone to know that Carter wasn't to be the thing? It had the friction drive and no other car had it. How could I tell what these engineers would say next?" By the time Durant had regained control of General Motors in 1915, the GM board had already decided to discontinue the Carter Car, largely because sales never approached the 1,000 to 2,000 annually that Durant had predicted. The GM board decided to use the factory instead to produce the Oakland. Durant had arranged an $8 million deal to buy Ford in 1909, but the bankers turned him down and the board of directors of General Motors dismissed him. Both Durant and rival Henry Ford foresaw the automobile becoming a mass market item. Ford followed the course of the basic Model T, and had said any customer can have a car painted any color that he wants so long as it is black. Durant, however, drawing on his experience in the carriage business, sought to create automobiles targeted to various incomes and tastes. This brought about his plans to merge Buick with various other companies to serve this purpose. He purchased Cadillac, and in 1908 formed General Motors by consolidating 13 car companies and 10 parts and accessories manufacturers. Equals Chevrolet equals. In 1910, Durant became financially overextended and banking interests assumed control, forcing him from management of GM Holding. He immediately set out to create another GM, starting with the Little Car, named after its founder, William H. Little. His initial intention was to compete with the Ford Model T, then beginning to show its impending popularity. Unsatisfied with this approach, however, he abandoned it and went into partnership with Louis Chevrolet in 1911, after obtaining a loan of $52,935.25 on September 30, 1910, in Canada, co-signed by R.S. McLaughlin, starting the Chevrolet Company. Before long, a disagreement with Louis Chevrolet resulted in Durant buying out his partner in 1914. Durant went to McLaughlin in 1915 to put Chevrolet in Canada, and with the shares being bought up at 5-1 and 7-1, McLaughlin and Durant with other shareholders had enough stock to reclaim Durant's old job. McLaughlin had no problem with his friend back at the helm. McLaughlin went on building Chevrolet and built his Buicks in Canada without conflict to his Buick contract. General Motors Corporation was started at this time, with Durant putting Pierre DuPont in charge, with McLaughlin director and vice president of the newly incorporated General Motors Corporation in 1918. Nevertheless, the venture was so successful for Durant, he was able to buy enough shares in GM to regain control, becoming its president in 1916. During his presidency from 1916-1920, Durant brought the Chevrolet product line into the corporation in 1919, as well as Fisher Body and Frigidaire. Mackinac News. In 1920, he finally lost control of GM to the DuPont and McLaughlin shareholders, paying out $21 million back to his friends. While in charge of Chevrolet, Durant acquired other companies, including Republic Motors, mainly to produce Chevrolet. Equals vertical integration equals, drawing on his experience in the carriage making business 20 years earlier, Durant also assembled a collection of parts and components manufacturers into a new entity called United Motors Company, making Alfred P. Sloan of Hyatt Roller Bearing Company the president. It was made up of Hyatt Roller Bearing, New Departure Manufacturing, Dayton Engineering Laboratories, Harrison Radiator Corporation, Remy Electric, Jackson Steel Products, and Perlman Rim. In 1918, United Motors was sold to General Motors for $44,065,000. Sloan rose to president of GM in the 1920s, going on to build the company into the world's largest automaker. Equals Durant Motors equals, in 1921, Durant established a new company, Durant Motors, initially with one brand. Within 2 years, it had a variety of marks, including the Durant, Star, Flint, and Eagle, rivaling the range offered by General Motors. Part of the new empire included a factory in Leaside, Ontario, for Canadian production. As he had with General Motors, Durant acquired a range of companies whose cars were aimed at different markets. The cheapest brand was the Star, aimed at the person who would otherwise buy the obsolescent Model T, while the Durant cars were mid-market. The Princeton line competed with Packard and Cadillac, and the ultra-luxurious Locomobile was the top of the line. However, he was unable to duplicate his former success, and the financial woes of the Wall Street crash of 1929 and the ensuing Great Depression proved fatal, as the company failed in 1933. Wall Street and later years. In the 1920s, Durant became a major player on Wall Street and on Black Tuesday joined with members of the Rockefeller family and other financial giants to buy large quantities of stocks, against the advice of friends, to demonstrate to the public their confidence in the stock market. His effort proved costly and failed to stop the market slide. By 1936, the 75-year-old Durant was bankrupt. After the fall of Durant Motors, Durant and his second wife, Catherine Leader Durant, lived on a small pension provided by R.S. McLaughlin, Mr. Ma and DuPont, as arranged by Alfred P. Sloan, at $10,000 a year on behalf of General Motors. He suffered a stroke in 1942, which left him a semi-invalid, and managed a bowling alley, slinging hamburgers in Flint until his death in 1947. He was interred in a private mausoleum at the Woodlawn Cemetery in the Bronx, New York. He was inducted into the Junior Achievement U.S. Business Hall of Fame in 1996. Durant Park in Lansing, Michigan, is named after him. Durant's Castle. During the late 1920s, Durant's son, Russell Clifford Durant, and his third wife, Lee Gabsky Durant, started construction on a personal castle and private airstrip in Roscommon, Michigan, along the south branch of the Orsable River. The 54-room mansion burned to the ground under mysterious circumstances on February 6, 1931. The Durants never inhabited it. Arson was suspected, allegedly at the hands of trade unionists, whom Durant had refused to recognize. After Lee's mysterious disappearance in 1934, and Cliff's death in 1937, Cliff's fourth wife, Charlotte Phillips Durant, sold the land to George W. Mason, an automotive executive. Upon his death, it was bequeathed to the state of Michigan as a nature preserve, the Mason Tract. All that remains of the castle and private airstrip are the old foundation works. Today, a canoe landing and short history of the castle are on the site. References. Further reading, Pelfrey, William. Billy, Alfred and General Motors. Amicom Publishing. Madsen, Axel. The Dealmaker, How William C. Durant Made General Motors. Wiley Publishing. Guston, Lawrence. Billy Durant, Creator of General Motors. University of Michigan Press. ISBN 978-0-472-03302-7. External links, Billy Durant and the Founding of General Motors, Durant, William Crapo, William C. Durant at Find a Grave, Durant Motors Automobile Club, DurantCars.com at www.durantcars.com, History of Durant, Hear Billy Durant Speak.